our Lord Jesus Christ, and I pray as David did in Psalm 19, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. The title of my message today is Forgive as We Have Been Forgiven. Once again, we're talking about the topic of forgiveness. Do you think that's a really big deal if we talk about it so much? Jesus talks about it a lot, and it is a big deal. It is a big deal. As Christians, we are commanded to forgive one another. We are commanded and we will be forgiven as we forgive others. That's what we pray in the Lord's Prayer. It is part of who we are as Christians. Now, Joseph forgives his brothers for selling them into slavery, and Jesus tells Peter to keep forgiving others as many times as it takes. As many times as it takes. Gives a number, but it really means just keep forgiving. God's forgiveness is infinite. How can we count the times he has forgiven us? We are in debt to our Lord Jesus Christ because he keeps our secrets. He knows who we really are. He knows what we've really done. And he is not saying. If we ask for forgiveness, he forgives us. Now, I've read and reread this book because I struggle so much with forgiveness, and I think we all do. It's called Total Forgiveness, and it's written by a pastor. His name is R.T. Kendall, who also had trouble with forgiveness. And he talks here about totally forgiving people. And how do we do that? He gives us some insights and mechanics for doing that. And I would like to share some of those with you today. There are many people that I have in my life that I have not totally forgiven. I admit that. And I think to some extent we all have people in our lives that we can't forgive. Some people who are living, some people who have died. Sometimes we can't forgive because of something that was done to us. Sometimes we can't forgive because it was something done to someone we love. And it's hard. And we keep rehearsing the hurt. We keep rehearsing the hurt and the bitterness because we believe that if we forget what this person did, they will never be punished. They will never be punished. And that's really what we want when we harbor resentment and bitterness in our hearts. R.T. Kendall says that grieves the Holy Spirit inside of us. He wants every part of us so that he can help us become more like Jesus. If we harbor bitterness and resentment in our hearts, he grieves for us. We cannot think clearly. When we rehearse this stuff over and over and over again, it takes up too much of our brain. And the Holy Spirit wants every part of us, all of our brain, all of our body. He wants to continue to help us be who we were created to be. And I think that's a great insight. Think about that. Bitterness stops the Holy Spirit from working in life. Now, it leaves us also vulnerable to Satan's suggestions. Right? You're saying, I've been hurt, I've been hurt, I've been hurt. And self-pity, all of that gives Satan a foothold in your life. No, we don't want that either, do we? Grieves the Holy Spirit, gives Satan a foothold in your life. Now, there are a variety of hurts and wounds that we receive from others. Some are more serious than others. Now, being abused in any form, either the abuse directed at us or a vulnerable loved one, can make it seem justified to hold on to forgiveness, unforgiveness, rather, to hold on to that resentment. But we get mixed up. Forgiving does not mean that we trust that again. Trust is a process. If the person is not trustworthy, we can forgive them, but we don't need to be their best friend. We don't need to seek them out and be their best friend, or seek them out to be with at all. But we can forgive them. We can give up that record in our minds about all the stuff, all the resentments. Forgiving means to let somebody off the hook and trust that God can judge him or her, and justice will be done, but not our justice, God's perfect and holy justice. Now, there are a couple of things that I'd like to say, more practical things, about forgiveness and letting go of resentment. Easier said than done, first of all. Every time you start thinking about that hurt, every time you think about the resentment and you begin to become resentful and bitter, stop. Just stop the minute that you feel that resentment, that rehearsal of that unforgiveness. Stop. Don't tell anyone else about this hurt except for one trusted person. One. Otherwise, what happens? You are gossiping. You are slandering. You are killing that person's reputation. Keep quiet. Joseph sent away all the servants before he talked to his brothers. He did not want his brothers to be embarrassed. He did not want his brothers to be scared of him. He did not want his brothers to be slandered by everyone in Egypt, because Joseph was a high mucky muck. And if people knew that his brothers were that bad to him, they would refuse to be with them. They would cut them off. So don't talk to other people about your hurt. You are gossiping. It makes you look better. It makes them look worse. And you think you're giving them what they deserve. And you can justify it. But stop and think. Go to one trusted friend, one person, one advisor. Then secondly, when you meet them, be pleasant to them. Do not make them be anxious around you and around others. Jesus did this with his disciples. Remember, they all ran away when he got crucified. And when he was resurrected and he came in to see them, they were hiding in the upper room, right? And what is the first thing he says to them? Peace be with you. He didn't want them to feel anxious or upset because they did this thing. Does that make sense? Do not try to make people anxious around you. Do not guilt trip them, thirdly. Don't put guilt on them. Don't make them feel guilty. Treat them as if the hurt never happened. Fourthly, never remind them of the wrong that they did. Let them feel normal or feel good about themselves. Do not make them feel guilty. Do not make them feel that they owe you something. Fifth, if you do know some deep, dark secret of theirs, never share it. Keep it confidential. It's so easy to get revenge by saying something about somebody else that they said in confidence to you that really makes them look bad. Don't do it. And then sixth, total forgiveness is a lifelong commitment. You, like Jesus says today, you have to do it over and over and over again. Those tapes start playing in your head. You have to stop it. And you have to think, I am giving that resentment up today. I'm giving that bitterness up today. I want the Holy Spirit to work in and through me today. And lastly, and this is the best part, you pray for them. And you pray that Jesus blesses them. You pray that They are closer to Jesus because every day you bless them. You bless them. Now, I'm saying you, and I mean we. And I hate that because I'm a teacher. I always say you. I meant we because I do the same thing. You know, it's we all have trouble with forgiveness. But if you can give that resentment up, if you can stop those tapes from the those hurt tapes from playing, I guess they're DVDs these days or MP3s or I don't know. But at any rate, and then take that next step to bless them, you are released. You are released. There are people who are sick, physically sick, from not forgiving. People miraculously get better when they forgive and they bless others. So there's physical reasons for you to forgive. Besides, Jesus tells us this is how we're supposed to behave. And we've got lots of good examples in the Bible. So that's what I wanted to say to you today. And I would like to pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, thank you, thank you, thank you for your son Jesus. Thank you for Joseph. Thank you for all of those characters in the Bible who acted as if people did not hurt them. They forgave them from their heart. We thank you for that. Holy Spirit, the last thing we want to do is grieve you. So as soon as we feel our bitterness and resentment coming back, let us give it up. Let us give it up to you. Help us to remember to treat other people with mercy and forgiveness as Jesus has forgiven us. And help us to remember to forgive as many times as it takes. We thank you, Jesus, for your example. We thank you, Father God, for not telling our secrets. And we thank you, Holy Spirit,